Please welcome Vice President, Incident Response and Cloud Operations, Varonis, Matt Radolec.
Hello, everyone. It's great to be here at RSA Conference 2025. Thanks for attending my session, From Gamer to Leader, How to Build Resilient Cyber Teams. Show of hands, are there any gamers out there? Where are my monster hunters at? My dragon slayers? What about role players? Any chicken dinner winners? Yeah, there's a couple of you. What about 90s crankers? Are you out there? COD fraggers? Noob tubers? Racing sim fanatics? I'm one of those. Candy crushers? There we go. Where are y'all at? I know you're out there. Well, gamers, I've got to ask you something. Did anyone ever tell you that gaming wouldn't get you anywhere in life? Well, I know better than that. I'm a gamer too. My name is Matt Radolec, and at the young age of 13, I stood tall and proud, a night elf hunter, top damage dealer, and raid leader for my guild in World of Warcraft. I've led raids of 40 middle-aged men and women into battle. I've grinded the leaderboards in Counter-Strike, PUBG, and Fortnite, and even gotten a world-first boss kill in World of Warcraft. But my most proud gaming accomplishment was sitting atop Choco Taco and Shroud in the North American first-person solo PUBG leaderboards. And I have to admit, thank you, that took a lot more grinding than I care to tell anyone. Now, what does all this mean? I think gamers are the most untapped talent pool in the workforce today, and they are ideal for cybersecurity. And in this presentation, I'm going to show you why. Everything that I learned as a gamer was leveraged to build, invent, and lead the world's fastest growing AI-powered managed detection and response service for your data, Varonis Managed Data Detection and Response. I've always dreamed of being a protector for the world and its data, and now I stand here bursting with excitement, delivering an RSA keynote at RSA Conference 2025. I get to live out my dreams every single day. So, if you think that there is a skill or a worker shortage in cybersecurity, think again. There is a magical hidden talent pool inside the gaming and esports community, and we are living proof. Today, I'll take us on a legendary quest where I'll show you how to turn gamers into leaders. Along the way, you'll earn three achievements. First, why you should recruit gamers and embrace their skills. Second, how to challenge gamers by giving them quests filled with opportunities to achieve, level up, and grow. And third, how if you equip gamers with the right weapons, you can watch them become heroes. So, why should you recruit gamers? Why should you embrace their skills? What is it about gamer personalities that makes them a fit for recruiting into cybersecurity? Well, gamers love to strategize. They're highly adaptable. Today's mission might involve learning about scattered spider, multi-factor authentication, or the next.js middleware vulnerabilities. But tomorrow, we might need to take down a different dragon, like securing Kubernetes. And gamers, they love these sorts of quests. They see it as a milestone, an achievement, to level up their career and to grow as a person. So if you want to earn your first achievement, recruit gamers and embrace their skills, let's look at how prevalent video gaming already is in cybersecurity. We've got things like bug bounties, capture the flag. We've got threat actors, or dungeon bosses, as I would refer to them. And we've got the personification of heroes as cyber defenders. Let's take a look at bug bounties for just a minute. We've all seen bounty boards in video games. Find this monster and slay it for a few gold pieces, or a new sword. Collect 10 iron ore and turn it in for a magical potion. In cybersecurity, bounties are used to encourage vulnerability hunters, reverse engineers, and penetration testers to identify exploitable weaknesses in software, hardware, and cloud in order to collect fat stacks of cash or to increase awareness of their company and its brand. Varonis security researchers from Varonis Threat Labs, they chase bug bounties as a full-time job. And guess what? They're all gamers. They found ghost sites, left-behind Salesforce sites that inadvertently expose sensitive data. They discovered secret agents, which were vulnerable, credential-exposing components of Okta infrastructure, and log crushers, which were different ways to manipulate and control security events in the Windows operating systems. Now, I bet everybody here loves a good game of Capture the Flag. Has anyone ever participated in a cyber Capture the Flag event? I know there's some SANS instructors speaking later. They do these all the time. These are great simulation and practice exercises for blue teams and red teams to test their defenses against simulated real-world threats and actors. Some common scenarios might include a pre-recorded set of attacks and needing to find the breadcrumbs that were left by the attackers. Other scenarios might include walking into an insecure environment ripe with exposure and needing to harden it before the impending offensive from the security researchers and the pen testers. Capture the Flag events create safe spaces for cyber warriors to harden their skills where the stakes are low, but the capacity for learning is immense. The gamification of monsters is in nearly every video game and is extremely prevalent in cyber. Scattered spider, mummy spider, cozy bear, fancy bear, all these animals that seem like they're mythological creatures or maybe not so difficult bosses to fight in a game. Mummy spider, if you guys didn't know, was behind Emotet. The bear actors are frequently tied to Russian military and intelligence units, and Scattered Spider just loves bypassing multi-factor authentication. So, are we all living in the Matrix? Is it all just a game? The heroes of the story, they get personified too. We have Defenders of the Realm, like Protector 22814, a hero archetype that demonstrates Varonis' mastery in robotics, automation, and AI. And Protector even has a cat. Who doesn't love cats? If this isn't convincing enough for you to see why you should recruit gamers and embrace their skills, I've got one more thing. Do you know that by recruiting gamers, you can recruit more women? Yeah, let's hear it. Where are the ladies of RSA conference at? 46% of gamers in the US are female, while only 30% of the cyber workforce is women. Well, congrats. We've completed our first quest, and you're ready to recruit gamers. You see that we've all been gaming in plain sight all this time. Recruiting gamers is only the start of our journey, though. We as leaders must send gamers on quests to give them a path to grow, succeed, and level up. Gamers love quests. They pride themselves on achievement. They thrive in environments where they can try new tactics, solve problems, and gain new skills. And as leaders, it's our duty to create those quest lines. We must send our employees on these journeys. We have to create the talent trees and lay the paths for a lowly mage with a wood staff and some basic spells to travel the realm and emerge victorious, reborn, a fire mage. What does this mean for cybersecurity, though? In cyber, this means helping a security analyst from a security operations center or a managed detection and response team hone their incident investigation and handling skills and start to manage incidents, ultimately one day donning a new role as a major incident commander. Incident commanders are responsible for coordinating investigation, response, and remediation activities across disparate teams. They also give executive wrap-up summaries to members of the board and the management team of large public and privately held companies. So, you get it now. Recruiting gamers is a must. Giving gamers quest lines is an absolute requirement in order to motivate them and keep them leveling up their skills. But how do you turn your team of gamers into superstars? How do you make these gamers heroes? Well, this probably isn't going to come as a surprise to anyone, but I couldn't get a keynote slot at RSA Conference 2025 and not talk about AI. Come on, they give me a quota, okay? And what I have to say to you is that it's naive in today's age to look at your worker and your employee skill progression as linear when we're dealing with AI. Let me explain. We as leaders have to think about the tools that we provide our teams and how AI-powered tool sets can be major stat boosts and level ups for every single person in our organizations. At Varonis, we are all about automation. We want 90% of the effort to be done by Varonis employees, our robots, and our AI, leaving only 10% of the work for our customers. That same mindset applies to how much of the analysis, investigation, and response work is done by our AI security analysts versus our human analysts. The AI security analyst that we built works alongside our human analysts to investigate and triage 100% of the alerts that are triggered for our customers. It even actions and auto decisions more than half of them. AI is doing the mundane. It's saving the juiciest, the most important, and the most complex work, the best work for humans. Investigations like why a human resources person is accessing source code, or why a service account for an ERP application is trying to spin up a Kubernetes cluster in AWS and dump a database export as a text file. With this AI-enabled toolkit, our analysts are super efficient and highly accurate. This ultimately helps us be precise and accurate with our investigations, but also fast and efficient with our time, delivering the best service to you, our customers, and delivering the best outcomes for data. Keeping data safe from cyber threats, insider threats, and privacy and compliance violations 24/7, 365. And when we took a step back from this accomplishment, we realized that giving Varonis analysts this toolkit, partnering them with this AI analyst, was like giving them a mythical sword. Equipped with these weapons, they have the upper hand against threat actors. They are unstoppable. They are the heroes of data. They are playing to win. So, you like the achievement, right? You've recruited gamers, you've given them a quest line to level up, and you've armed them with the tools that they need to become superstars. Now you're ready to come with me on a raid. Let's assemble our team, let's understand the quest at hand, and let's slay that monster and take down a sophisticated threat actor. The first thing that we need to do is understand the threat actor. Who is this boss? What are we fighting? And what are their tactics, techniques, and protocols? Scattered Spider is a cyber criminal group that targets large companies, typically through their IT help desk and trusted third parties. What they aim to do is steal data, extort, and they're commonly associated with the Black Cat and Alpha V ransomware variant. Scattered Spider hackers often use remote access tools for initial access. They continue their masquerade as IT help desk employees in efforts to lure users to giving up their multi-factor authentication codes and one-time passcodes. When that doesn't work, they overwhelm users with MFA requests, which we call MFA fatigue attacks. They've even been known to capture cell phones and SIM cards and take over phones in order to answer the MFA prompts themselves. All of these efforts by Scattered Spider is to take and monetize the foothold that they have over a company in order to enable ransomware and data theft. And so with this understanding of the boss that we're up against, we can start to recruit our team. So to thwart Scattered Spider, what do we need? Well, we need incident handlers, because we're probably going to walk into compromised machines, compromised devices, and we're going to need to look through logs. We need forensic experts. Undoubtedly, we're going to encounter a device that we need to dump memory on and maybe even extract a binary from. We need identity experts. Why is that? Because Scattered Spider typically does things like reuse credentials and does brute force attacks and other ways of logging in and fraudulently impersonating users. And we also need security researchers. Because when we find a binary that we don't recognize or isn't picked up by something like antivirus or EDR, we need to be able to reverse it to understand how they got that foothold and how their command and control infrastructure works. So we've got a plan. We've got our superstar team, and now we can save the princess. I mean the data. After all, that is the real point of security, right? To make sure our data is safe. So what our team did is they looked far and wide for signs of brute force attacks. They looked for MFA fatigue. They looked for the reconnaissance of data. So with swords and shields drawn, what we did together was repel the continuous attempts from that actor to establish footholds using things like remote access trojans. We made it so that Scattered Spider exhausted their resources and lost their ground. When they made a mistake, we were able to get a hold of a binary for their beacon, and then the threat researchers got to do their magic. They could reverse those beacons, they could look at those binaries, and give us the secret weapon to eradicate that actor and eliminate their command and control infrastructure. We knew now any systems and accounts that they had compromised. We were now able to take them offline. All this was done before the princess, I mean data, was lost. We slayed this spider, at least for now. Now what a legendary journey that this has been. With your three new hard-earned achievements, you can build resilient cyber teams by recruiting and mentoring gamers. You know why you need to recruit gamers. You now know that you need to send gamers on quests in order to level up their skills. And you know how to equip them with the tools that they need to make them superheroes, to make them heroes of data. Now you can go and take down any dragons and any threat actors that are knocking at your door and that of your organization. So, if you want to meet the real heroes of data, stop by the Varonis booth at Moscone North 5658. And thank you. This talk was made possible by you, the gamers of the world. You are the future of cybersecurity.